a little intimidating.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure that I'm not alone here in being a little bit in love with Emma Thompson. She's pretty remarkable. One day on the set of Nanny McPhee, Emma and I had heard that Clash of the Titans was filming right across the hallway, and we wanted to go and see some hot guys in loincloths. So we decided to make the trip over, and while we were walking over, we were musing about which Greek goddesses we would be if we were allowed to be in Clash of the Titans. And Emma, of course, was Athena, and she kindly let me be Aphrodite, and we were walking over and feeling really good about that. And we opened the door to a barrage of extraordinarily breathtakingly beautiful supermodels who were wearing metal underwear and shin guards, and they were actually playing Aphrodite and Athena. And then we sort of looked the other direction and saw what we'd come for, which was a group of very gorgeous and very oily men, indeed, in loincloths coming right toward us. Then I remembered the movie that we had been making, and I looked down at my costume, and I'm playing a farm girl, and I was wearing this very worn, very baggy house dress that was misbuttoned and covered in mud, and Emma was in a particularly unattractive Nanny McPhee moment with a huge nose and a fat suit. I felt this pang of envy for the gorgeous women, and I suddenly got very shy. Emma started charming the pants off of these people, flirting, and it was received extraordinarily well. Then we turned a corner and we saw Liam Neeson and Ralph Fiennes dressed in very little as Hades and Zeus. Now, we're both very happily married women, but that was a sight to behold, and I literally went in and clutched Emma's arm.
She was pathetic. She fell off.
True, but Emma, by the time we left, I mean, everybody was laughing. I think we made a date to meet Rafe and Liam for dinner and invited any one of the oily men who wanted to come. I don't know if
it's Tell me about that. I took my tits out.
Not the real ones, the pretend ones. But the point here is that through this costume, through her huge fake nose and warts and fat suit and braid and frizzy wig, Emma's essence came shining through, and I think Emma is undeniably graceful and good. I've never seen Emma where she hasn't given me a present, and a present for my daughter. She knows the name of every single person on the crew that she's working on, and their children and their wives' names. She cooked me roast beef and Yorkshire pudding while acting and writing and producing in a multi-million dollar huge studio movie. I think that she may actually be Athena. And this comes through in all of the things that she writes and the movies that she acts in. I mean, Sense and Sensibility, Remains of the Day, Howard's End, Jesus, it's really unbelievable. Love Actually, which I saw right after I got my wisdom teeth out and I was super high. I don't remember anything about that movie except her scene. I will proudly walk on your star with gratitude for everything that you've taught me. I thank God for you and I love you. Yeah.